One great way to paint your miniatures is as if they are ghosts, perhaps spooky apparitions from beyond the grave or foul beings from the warp. This technique is really fast to paint and looks great on just about any miniature, and we're going to show you how it works on this Chaos Space Marine, which we've already undercoated with Grey Seer. The first thing we're going to do is apply the spooky green washes to the model, and we're going to be using Hexwraith Flame first of all, and then some washes of Coelia Green shade. So we're going to take our medium shade brush here, and to apply a little bit of Hexwraith Flame onto our palette like so. We're not going to be thinning this down, but we just want to make sure we're not overloading the brush too much. And then, once we've got enough on the brush like so, we're just going to apply it all over the model like this. Now, you'd want to be quite liberal with this wash, make sure it goes all over the entire model. Make sure you're using the brush to avoid pooling on the model, and once the model has been covered with Hexwraith Flame, allow about 30 minutes for it to dry. It's been about 30 minutes and the Hexwraith Flame has dried, giving this really cool ghosty looking effect. Well, the next thing we're going to do is add Coelia Green shade into the recesses of the model using a medium layer brush. This will help break up the figure and add a little bit of contrast between areas. Again, you don't have to be too neat with this because the green will make it look ghostly. So the Coelia Green shade has dried on the model, and you can see we've applied it into the recesses, but also onto certain areas of the model, like the shoulder pad rims, and the bolt gun casing, and the knife blade, and this will help break up the solid green colour of that model. Alright, the next thing we're going to do is apply a dry brush all over the model using Ulthuin Grey. This will help pick out the raised areas of the figure, but also make it look a bit more pale and ghostly. We'll use a medium dry brush for this, and we've already got a piece of tissue prepared. I'm just going to take a little bit of paint from the pot like so, and just wipe off most of it onto the piece of tissue like this. I want to get rid of most of the paint off of the brush to help the dry brush go on much lighter. So here we go. And then I'm going to take the model and then just dry brush very carefully all over the model like so. You don't want to be too heavy with the dry brush here, just make sure you're applying light strokes. And the Ulthuin Grey dry brush is complete, giving a really cool pale and spooky look to the model. And the last thing we're going to do is add a little bit of colour to the model by making the eyes look like they're glowing red. We're going to start off with a layer of Caraberg Crimson, and then we're going to paint a dot of Wild Rider Red after that. We need a small layer brush here to make sure we're nice and controlled. Take a little bit of Caraberg Crimson out of our palette like so. Very, very carefully on the model, we're just going to apply it to the eyes like so. With the Caraberg Crimson dry, it's time to dot the eyes with a little bit of Wild Rider Red. And once this is dry, we're going to base the model and it'll be fully complete. So there we go, with the eyes and the base done, that is our model looking all spooky and ready for the battlefield. So there we go, that's the ghosty technique. It really is very fun and easy to apply to your miniatures. The thing to remember here is when applying the first wash is to apply it quite heavily, but also to use your brush to watch out for areas of pooling. Have fun trying this technique for yourself, and happy painting.